क्वेश्चन नंबर 136 Which of the following is incorrectly paired with its function? Incorrectly paired, they asked. First option, seminiferous tubules add fluids containing mucus, fructose, and prostaglandins to cement. Generally, seminiferous tubules, which contains two types of cells, sebaceous cells, germ cells. Sebaceous cells provide nourishment to the germ cells. Germ cells produce sperms. So there is no secretions of any fluids in the seminiferous tubules. So first option is not correct. Second, scrotum encloses testis. Yes, scrotum encloses testis. Correct. Epididymis is stores sperms, which temporarily stores sperms. So epididymis stores sperms. Correct. Prostate gland add alkaline secretion to sperm. Yes. Prostate gland, all the three types of glands secretes some secretions called seminal fluid. This prostate gland one of the accessory gland. Prostate glands, pair of accessory glands, other secretes alkaline fluid and adds to the cement. So, like we can observe 136, first option is incorrect. Next, 137, assertion we given, testes are retroperitoneal organs. Testes are enclosed in a scrotum that are covered by tunicae, tunica albuginea, tunica vaginalis, and tunica vasculosa. Like that, tunicae covers the testes. These testes are not retroperitoneal organs. Generally, retroperitoneal organs. Retroperitoneal organs means the organs which are present behind the abdomen, not present in the body cavity. Organs present behind the abdomen and which are covered by a peritoneum. So generally, kidneys are considered as retroperitoneal organs, not testes. So, assertion is not correct. Peritoneal layer covers the testes on the scrotal and the dorsal side. Testes covered by tunica albuginea on the dorsal side. Tunica that covers the testes, not peritoneal layer. So, reason also incorrect. So both assertion and reason are false. So fourth option for this. Next 137, 138. Choose the correct combination of labeling hormonal control of female reproductive system. Hormonal control they given hypothalamus. Which releases a hormone, dimension A, acts upon the anterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary releases two types of hormones that are acts upon the ovary. So, the hormones dimension B, ovary hormones released C, which in turn acts upon the D. Like that, they give it. Here, in female reproductive system, when we see hypothalamus releases a releasing hormone called gonadotropin releasing hormone. This gonadotropin releasing hormone acts upon the anterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary stimulates and secretes gonadotropins. Two gonadotropins are FSH, folic gland stimulating hormone, LH, luteinizing. Here, FSH induces folic gland maturation or folic gland development, ovarian follicles develops. LH induces ovulation. So, ovary stimulated by FSH and LH. So, ovary releases again which two types of hormones generally you can tell you, progesterone, major hormone secreted from the ovary. After some amount of estrogen also secreted from the ovary. So progesterone is the major hormone secreted from the ovary. So this progesterone mainly acts upon the uterine endometrium for maintenance of endometrium of the uterus. So like we can observe it is the positive feedback. Sometimes this positive feedback helpful to maintain the endometrium. So like we can observe in female reproductive system hormonal control where they mentioned gonadotropin releasing hormone, FSH, LH, luteinizing hormone, folic gland stimulating hormone, estrogen or progesterone. Progesterone, estrogen, uterus. So second option given for this 38. Second option is like arrange the events in woman female reproductive cycle. Female reproductive cycle is menstrual cycle. So menstrual cycle is the female reproductive cycle where the events occurs in the female reproductive cycle are secretion of FSH, growth of corpus luteum, growth of follicle and oogenesis, ovulation, sudden increase in the levels of LH. Like that they given female reproductive cycle events where we can observe first the secretion of FSH from the pituitary gland. So that FSH is helpful to induce follicular development. Follicular development occurs by the FSH. That's why you can observe FSH induces follicular development. So see growth of follicles and oogenesis is A. After maximum. FSH acts upon the follicles that cause growth of follicles. Follicular growth, you can tell oogenesis. Primary follicle into secondary follicle into tertiary follicle, graafian follicle or mature follicle like that oogenesis occurs by the hormone FSH. After follicular development, we can observe ovulation. So, they given that growth of follicular development and sudden increase in the levels of luteinizing hormone. So, when fully developed follicle is present in the ovary, that induces increase in the levels of luteinizing hormone. LH hormone levels increase. So, there we can observe increase, sudden increase in the levels of LH. LH helpful to rupture the matured follicle and causes ovulation. So ovulation occurs after increase the luteinizing hormone. So we can observe ovulation. So ovulation is sudden increase after sudden increase of luteinizing hormone. The luteinizing hormone acts upon the developed follicle. Follicle ruptured releases sperm. Releasing of secondary oocyte is called as ovulation. So ovulation occurs. So after ovulation, remaining part of the matured follicle or remaining part of graafian follicle is converted to कार्पस लूटियम. सो कार्पस लूटियम इज डेवलप्ड. डेवलपमेंट ऑफ कार्पस लूटियम अकर्स आफ्टर ओवुलेशन. आफ्टर ओवुलेशन द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ द एग ग्रैबियन फॉलिकल कन्वर्ट इनटू कार्पस लूटियम व्हिच हेल्पफुल फॉर द सेक्रेशन ऑफ प्रोजेस्टेरोन. प्रोजेस्टेरोन हेल्पफुल टू मेंटेन द एंडोमेट्रियम. सो लाइक दीज आर द इवेंट्स अकर इन ऑर्डर इन फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. सेक्रेशन ऑफ FSH व्हिच हेल्पफुल फॉर फॉलिकुलर ग्रोथ. फॉलिकुलर ग्रोथ अकर्स साइमल्टेनियसली. ल्यूटिनाइजिंग हार्मोन लेवल्स इंक्रीज व्हेन ग्रैबियन फॉलिकल इज प्रेजेंट. ल्यूटिनाइजिंग हार्मोन रप्चर्स द मैच्योर्ड फॉलिकल induces ovulation. Ovulation releases secondary oocyte. Remaining part of the ovulation convert into gametes. So like you can observe SCE DB are the events firstly. So on the 9 first option is. So next one part is which set of enzymes is found in the acrosoma mammalian spermatozoa. So mammalian spermatozoa contains enzymes with acrosome. Sperm acrosome that is filled with enzymes called as sperm lysins. Sperm lysins are the enzymes which are present in the sperm acrosome. Sperm lysins includes corona penetrating enzyme, zona lysin, acrosin, and the hyaluronidase. So these are the enzymes which are present in the acrosome. We can observe hyaluronidase dissolve the corona radiation and the corona penetrating enzyme helpful to dissolve the corona radiation cells and penetrates to near the zona pellucida. Zona pellucida dissolved by the zona lysin or acrosin. Acrosin or zona lysin which dissolves the zona pellucida, sperm enters into the secondary oocyte. So like these are the three enzymes which are present in the acrosome that constitute for sperm lysis. You can observe hyaluronidase, corona penetrating enzyme and zona lysin also called as acrosin. So like you can observe for one part second option. 141. Mark the incorrect statement. So incorrect statement, labia majora is homologous to the scrotal sac of male. Yes. In female, external genitalia contains labia majora. Labia majora and labia minora. Labia majora is homologous to scrotal sac in the male reproductive, because this scrotum and labia majora and the same tissue. So that's why you can tell homologous organs. Homologous to scrotum in same way, labia minora is not homologous. It is the inner folding. Outer folding is called as labia majora. Inner folding is called as labia minora. Labia minora is not homologous to scrotum. Clitoris is homologous to penis in males. Yes. Clitoris. An erectile tissue present in the female reproductive female external genitalia. This erectile tissue made up of same type of tissue as we see in the penis of male. So both are homologous. So homologous are the ones which are structurally similar, functionally not similar, because phytolysin is not a copulatory organ, but penis is a copulatory organ in best. So structurally which are made up of same type of tissue, that's why you can observe clitoris is homologous to the penis in main reproductive system. So that is also same way. Labia minora is homologous to scrotal sac. So labia minora is not homologous to scrotal sac. So third option is incorrect. Again, posterior gland secretions contains enzyme fibrinolysin. Yes, fibrinolysin, lysin, which helps to dissolve the clotted semen in female reproductive system, which is present in the secretions of prostate gland. So, prostate gland secretes fibrinolysin. This fibrinolysin helps to dissolve the clotted semen after ejaculation in female reproductive system. That's why you can tell fibrinolysin is present in the secretions of prostate gland. Let's start again. So, what's part given?
Of only 4 persons.
So on part 2, identify A, B, C, D, E, F and G in the diagram, sectionality of female reproductive system. Where they given female reproductive system. In that female reproductive system, not identify the lamellings, where innermost layer is called as endometrium, innermost layer of the uterus, middle layer of the uterus, myometrium, outer layer of the uterus, perimetrium. Same way, fallopian tubes, this part is called as isthmus, ampulla, infundibula, and uterus opens as a cervix. So like you can observe this. So think here, in the form there are the uterus, endometrium, next to this middle layer myometrium, and outer layer perimetrium. Isthmus of the fallopian tube, narrow isthmus and a wide ampulla where the fertilization occurs, and infundibulum, G cells. So like we can observe, the option which is given to 142 is 4. Next, female external genitalia do not include. Suddenly, female external genitalia includes mons pubis, labia majora, labia minora, clitoris and hymen. Now, given that vagina and cervix fourth option. So, vagina is considered as external genitalia, but cervix is not considered as external genitalia. So, cervix is a part of accessory duct. It is a part of accessory duct or part of uterus. Cervix are generally uterus. Anterior portion is called as fundus. Posterior portion is called as cervix. That's why this cervix is not considered as external genitalia. So remaining all are considered as external genitalia, but cervix is not considered as external genitalia. So 143, prone part. Next 144, assertion. Blood flowing in umbilical cord of woman embryo is 100% fetal. Yes. From the fetus. From the fetus, blood flows through the umbilical cord. Blood flows through the umbilical cord is 100% fetal blood, because mother blood, fetal blood is not mixed anywhere. Fetal blood is well separated by the placenta by mother's blood. So both are separated. So umbilical cord connected to the fetus, but umbilical cord contains 100% fetal blood. Umbilical cord helps in transport of substances between fetus and umbilical. Yes. Substances which is diffused, exchange of substances occurs between the mother and the fetus through the placenta. So this umbilical cord connects the fetus and placenta. So it's helpful to exchange the substances mother to mother and. So both are correct, but not correct the explanation for 144. So 144 is second option. Next, choose the incorrect statement. Gonorrhea, chancroid and syphilis are bacterial diseases. Yes, gonorrhea caused by Neisseria gonorrhea, chancroid also bacterial disease, syphilis also bacterial disease. So first option is correct, not correct. Genital herpes, genital loss is viral disease. Yes. Herpes simplex virus, human papillomavirus, HIV virus, viral disease. Tubectomy has many side effects. No. So tubectomy generally which is done in females. Tubectomy is done in females. They ask that tubectomy provides many side effects in males. Generally, males, we can observe vasectomy is a surgical operation in males. Tubectomy, so it has many side effects in males means not correct. So 145, third option. Third option is incorrect. Choose the correct statement regarding JIT procedure. JIT, zygote intrafallopian transfer, where zygote is formed in a test tube. That zygote transferred to the fallopian tubes. So intra fallopian transfer, zygote intra fallopian. So zygote which is collected and transferred to the fallopian. So right, we can observe intra zygote intra fallopian transfer, zygote transfer to the fallopian tubes. If early embryo when transferred to the uterus, that also you can call JIT or intrauterine transfer. But here zygote should be transferred to the fallopian tubes. Early embryo transferred to the uterus, or early embryo also you can call transferred to the fallopian. So like we can observe zygote intrafallopian transfer, transfer of zygote into the fallopian tube. They given that 146, second option.
One time meeting last.